Okay, so where we're up to right now, we've got one wing built. I want to build out this back wing. And then we've got the tail fin, the cockpit, and sort of the two intakes along the bottom to build. And then finally we're going to wrap up with the propeller. So let's take a look at this back wing first. I'm going to go into my side view. I don't really actually have a lot of faces here to work with on this. So I'm going to try, see if I can get these just two faces to the center. See what I can do with these. I'm going to hit extrude the selected face and immediately grab my scale tool, flatten this in just a little bit, and maybe move it out just to give a little section of width. From the top view, if it's spacebar twice to go to the top view, I can see exactly where I'm positioning this, and I now see just how much further in I want to bring these vertices. Here are my two faces. Let me come in, I'll hit extrude the selected face again, and I will scale this out all the way the length of the wing. Scale it together in all these axes just to make sure it fits. And I'm also probably going to taper it just a little bit. Now, I don't really have the ability to round this form out at all because I don't actually have enough vertices to do so. But I think we've kept this fairly low poly for now. And if we want to actually add in more edges through this when we're done, we can do that when we're done, but I'm going to leave that for later. I'm trying to keep this as simple as possible. I'll go to normals, soften edge. We'll see, this actually works pretty nicely. And if I actually look in my channel box, this is something we haven't been doing, check out all of the history which is piled up on this model. That is inexcusable at this point. It's a really good time to come in, edit, delete all by type history, remove all that out, and then let's save our scene as a version 4. Well, I'm ready to build out that tail rudder, and let's see what we can do to build this. I'm looking from the top view, and I already noticed at this point probably needs to be pulled forward to accommodate that tail rudder section. And I think what we're going to do is we're going to take these top two faces right here, and I'm going to scale these up. First, going to hit extrude, grab R for the scale tool, and if you notice what happens here, this is actually going to be somewhat painful. It's going to make two separate fin sections. Now, this plane doesn't have two fins, but because of the fact that we're working off of that center line, we've got to be extremely careful with what we create. In fact, I don't actually want these two center faces, or four as the case may be, two on each side. So I'm going to select them and delete them out, which means that now my vertices are off that center line. Well, I'm going to select these vertices one at a time and snap them back to the center. I can do this by using the snap to commands, the general little magnets in your status line. In fact, if I hold down X, in fact, X is like a little grid, it's actually the hotkey for snap to grid, and I don't know if you'll notice in video, but the magnet is being depressed for snap to grid. And if I hold down X while moving, it's going to not allow me to move this freely, but make sure that it's snapped to grid as I go. So if I hold down X and just push that red arrow, I can zipper this back up. And that's going to be very, very helpful for me as I try and round this out, which is what I'm going to try and do from the front here. I want to try and produce a thicker front and a more tapered back, just like we looked at with the wings. So let's see, I've got to actually put this all the way back here. And this guy's got to go all the way up here. But that's going to give us a pretty good little base section for which to produce this tail fin out of. I'm also going to pull these up just a little bit. I'll grab these two central faces by holding down shift and hit extrude the selected face. And again, because I don't like the manipulator all that much, I'm going to immediately hit W for the move tool and move this straight up. And we've got a tail fin. That tail fin, of course, looks all manner of wrong. So we're going to scale this together in the side view. And then using my vertices, I can position this to create some rounding by softening out this crease line. Pull each one of these back. And we're going to be pretty good, except for the fact that I also want to narrow this along the top. So to do that, I'm just going to take these vertices and manually move them a little bit thinner towards the center. Remember, each of your wings, you're trying to make feel like a knife, if you can. Let's create one more little edge loop through this midsection, just to kind of cut this down a little bit. And that's going to help me iteratively narrow this a little bit more before it reaches the top. Now you don't want to go too far as I've just done, or else you're going to go inside out here on your model, or actually take it off of the center line, which I did by accident. So if that's the case, just use X and resnap it to grid. I can use this as well to start to create a little bit more curvature in that form. Now, the problem with what I've created is actually not going to be readily apparent. One way to actually see the problem, which I'm going to show for you in just a second, it kind of has to do with the fact that this model is being so angular right now, and we want to come in and always soften our edges, not just to make it look less angular, but also to figure out where little mystery problems might happen. And you can see my crazy distorting airplane image plane behind. That's just a hardware error. Well, what's actually happening here, you can notice dark shading creases along this edge. You're not going to notice it unless you soften your edges for the model. But this is actually a huge problem for me. If I delete my left side, you can see it. I have four faces on the interior of my model. I always want to make sure that my model is working like an eggshell. And that means removing these faces out. So I'm going to delete them so that they're gone. And you'll notice that shading is going to right itself. Then I can just select my model, Control-Shift-D. Control-Shift-D, or go to Edit, Duplicate Special, and reduplicate this back across, and you won't notice that weird shading anymore. But it's a step that we really should take to make sure that we get rid of any sort of weirdness on the form. Now we are missing a cockpit still, and that's a big problem to me. So I'm going to want to actually come in and choose a section where we can establish this cockpit. Now, I've got a couple of faces positioned right here along this lower edge, and I'm actually trying to create a little selection area by rounding out the top of this form just a bit. And it's actually going to be very similar to the process that we just did with creating the tail fin, except now it's going to be a cockpit instead of being a fin. So I'm going to take these 10 faces, 5 on each side, once I've got them established, and I'm going to extrude them upwards to create my cockpit section. We're going to look at doing that and creating the other little parts in our next video.